Welcome to Skyscanner's online training module on anti-bribery and corruption. This module will cover the Bribery Act 2010 and the impact it has on Skyscanner. This is a mandatory training module and must be completed on an annual basis. In this session, you will learn the meaning of bribery under the law, why you need to know about the Act and who else needs to know, how to avoid criminal liability for you and also for Skyscanner, guidelines around gifts and hospitality, the action to take if you suspect or know of a bribe, what may constitute bribery offences through examples and scenarios. The Bribery Act amended previous legislation so that the law relating to anti-bribery was clear and contained. The Act is extremely far-reaching and allows for the prosecution of individuals and companies with links to the UK or a business presence in the UK, regardless of where an offence might occur. Any and all acts of bribery are not permitted. To understand the full implications, it is important to understand what bribery is defined as within the Act. The definition of bribery is giving someone a financial or other advantage to encourage that person to perform their functions or activities improperly, or to reward that person for having already done so. It is interesting to note that the advantage given does not necessarily have to be financial in nature. There are four offences under the Act: giving a bribe, receiving a bribe, failing to prevent a bribe, and this is the key offence that is relevant to Skyscanner as a corporate body can be liable here. And finally, bribing foreign public officials. This may include grease payments or facilitation payments, but can include any payment made to a public official that is not made legitimately, for example, in order to speed up a process at customs. The Serious Fraud Office is responsible for enforcing the Bribery Act. The head of the Serious Fraud Office has made it clear that he is keen to make an example of a company should they be found liable under the Act, and Skyscanner's unique brand profile and growth could make it an interesting target for the SFO to make an example of. The Act applies globally to any size of bribe where a business has a presence in the UK, which Skyscanner, of course, does. Any person or company working for or on behalf of Skyscanner in any capacity is within the scope of the Act. The Act is one of the strictest and far-reaching of its kind. It means that you could be criminally liable as an individual, and Skyscanner could also become criminally liable as a result of an offence committed by you.
Well, the authorities say that GlaxoSmithKline stands accused of serious economic crimes. According to officials, the firm may have spent hundreds of millions of dollars in bribes over several years. How did they do this? Well, according to officials here, they funneled money through travel agencies, and that was used to pay bribes to doctors and officials. Police also say that they're investigating what they've termed as sexual bribery.
Peter Humphrey says it was a show trial for the cameras, and that he and his wife, Yu Yingzheng, were collateral damage. They'd become embroiled in a bigger drama, a corruption investigation at GSK.
And we are talking about the most powerful sports organization possibly in the world that has raked in billions of dollars. These executives are charged with bribery and corruption. We want to bring in Matthew Garahan from the Financial Times. He's been listening to this press conference with us. Matthew, what's your takeaway right off the top?
Well, it's quite stunning, I think. I mean, you have this organization, FIFA, which is corrupt to the core, pretty much, and it's been able to act with almost impunity over the last 20 years, 30 years even. And finally, someone's tackled them, and you have the results of this long investigation. And I think it's overdue. I think those of us who've been watching FIFA and writing about FIFA over the years have always wondered how they managed to get away with it for so long, because they were clearly corrupt at every level. I mean, it's essentially a large criminal enterprise.
You are personally liable if you offer or receive a bribe. Skyscanner is responsible for the actions of employees or other people working on its behalf where they fail to prevent a bribe. Skyscanner may also be liable for third-party offenders, i.e., third-party companies that we're working with. You can also be liable if you turn a blind eye to illegal or suspicious activities, particularly if you are in a managerial position or have direct reports. Individuals found guilty of serious offences can face a potentially unlimited fine and up to 10 years imprisonment. Companies also face unlimited fines if they fail to prevent bribery. Any senior officers of a company may be personally liable where that company has been found guilty of an offence, if he or she is deemed to give consent to the offence. Any corporate conviction may exclude companies bidding for public contracts. Additionally, there would be serious adverse publicity if Skyscanner was investigated or convicted of a bribery offence. If an offence is deemed to have been committed, the default position is that Skyscanner would be liable under the Act. The only defence is if we can show that there were adequate procedures in place to the extent that the offence ought not to have been committed in the first place. The adequate procedures are risk assessment. We have carried out extensive risk assessment on the countries we operate in with some surprising results. China and parts of Southeast Asia are risky territories in this respect. Due diligence. It is essential to carry out due diligence on each company we deal with to minimize any risk of bribery offenses occurring as a result of our dealings with third-party companies. Communication. We ensure that people who work for us or on behalf of us are informed of our zero-tolerance policy on bribery and corruption. Top-level commitment. People at all levels in the company are involved in this commitment to keep Skyscanner a bribery-free zone. Monitoring and review. The strategy around anti-bribery is revisited frequently to make sure that it is implemented effectively and accurately. Proportionality. The procedures are proportional to the business they are seeking to protect. That concludes the first section of Skyscanner's anti-bribery training. Please answer the following series of questions before going on to view the second video. As this training is a legal requirement, there is a 100% pass mark.